looks of it.
On a remote lake in Guyana, I've just hooked a super-sized arapaima on a fly.
This is a large fish.
But I'm feeling massively undergunned.
Come
in. All I have to pull in this giant is a thin rod and a wobbly canoe.
That's the fish there.
I'm trying to stop the fish coming to the surface. If it jumps, it could spit out the hook. But it seems the fish is calling the shots.
Heavy fish. The rod. Painful curve.
As the fish comes closer, the danger becomes very real. If it jumps in our direction, the results could be deadly.
It's gonna jump.
This is a lot bigger than any arapaima I've caught before. I need to get it into the shallows.
In a bit more, please.
This fish weighs at least 250 pounds.
Keep holding. Design. Look at this. Arapaima on a fly. This thing. It's actually, I was going to say, it's built like a missile. This is a tired fish, believe it or not. Two of us can hardly restrain it. It is just, doesn't it look like a missile? Long, streamlined body. I think about three times the size of the one that hit me. Sent me flying, left me in pain for over a month. This thing came flying at you. Hit you in the right place, or we say the wrong place. You wouldn't know about it. Just a final flashing, fleeting moment, and then lights out for good. I think that's a strong fish.
This is the biggest fish of my South American fishing career. A river monster as deadly as any beast of folklore. And if you caught a glimpse of something this size, color, and shape appearing on the edge of your vision, your mind could fill in the gaps. Here in Guyana, where legends of mermaids pervade local beliefs, you might think that you've seen the water mama. But one thing's for sure, there are arapaima here so massive they could easily deliver a fatal blow.